I have always wanted to be a chemist, ever since the age of 12, when I stumbled across in my father's bookcase the Pelican Book of Explosives. And at that point I decided I wanted to become a chemist, before I really knew what chemistry was.
I was kind of torn between a lot of different courses, but after talking to my chemistry teacher at school, I thought, yeah, this is what I want to study.
It sounds fairly trivial, but I've always enjoyed chemistry.
I always wanted to know, like, why some things did what it did. And with chemistry, you get a lot of that understanding.
I'm sufficiently stubborn that I've stuck to it and become a chemist, even though I hasten to add I've never had anything to do with explosives. The philosophy of the course is to put together all the different bits of science that a chemist needs to know to understand how molecules work.
We have to do organic, inorganic and physical chemistry for all 3 years.
It sounds like a bad thing, but by the time you get to your fourth year, it means that you're able to have a decent conversation with any other chemist about what their research is.
The core part of the chemistry course is pretty rigid, and the core part of the course is the whole of the first year, and most of the second year and a bit of the third year.
Generally there's lectures every day, 9 till 11. And then some days I will have practicals, so I'll be in labs. And other days I'll either be doing tutorial work or having a tutorial or like doing my lab reports.
The main misperception about the Oxford course is that it's a very theoretical course and that practicals are not important. And I don't think that's true. We are trying to teach students to solve problems, but problems are not just paper problems.
It makes you very competent at handling numbers and handling facts and gearing those facts in a way to make them applicable to a problem.
We teach in a holistic way and we examine in a holistic way, so at the end of each year you get a set of exams which covers the whole course up to that point.
The third year exams, you could be asked about anything from all 3 years of Oxford.
Real problems aren't modular. You know, real problems in the real world, you have to use your imagination to solve them, and you have to link together all sorts of things you may not have thought of as being relevant.
A lot of courses, they sort of put the research over the 3 years in different places. It's very nice to have it as a separate unit and then have a published piece of work at the end.
In the fourth year, students can in principle work in a lab abroad, they can in principle work in a lab in industry, so long as the project that they've selected fits.
So that is the time then you, like, when you decide this is what I want, this area of chemistry is what I want to study, and then you do that for a full year, so you kind of become the expert in that area.
The research lab facilities in Oxford are probably the best in the UK in any university, and quite possibly the best in the world in any university. It has NMR spectrometers for hands-on use on every floor. It has gas chromatography, mass spectrometry routinely available.
I haven't had to buy that many textbooks because they already have them there.
The tutorial system is great. I mean, there really is no other place where you can get one-on-one time with leading professionals in chemistry, leading experts in their subject, and they're willing to sit you down for 2 hours a week and explain problems to you and have a conversation about chemistry, which is wonderful.
The fact that I can teach my students in usually pairs means that I can really focus on what they need, and it means that I get to know them really well.
You've got a lot of time to ask them questions, and they've got a lot of time to kind of push you and make you think about chemistry in a different way and like really try and stretch your understanding, which I think is great.
You've got to get used very, very quickly to just taking the initiative to finding the results, the answers yourself, rather than being given them. And that's something which I've enjoyed and I've become a lot better at.
There's always a point where people think, oh, I'm not supposed to be here, but one thing I wish I'd known is that a lot of people think that. So you're not the only one sitting there thinking that my tutor's made the wrong choice letting me in.
it's a great joy to teach Oxford students because they stretch me as much as I stretch them. And every time a student asks me a question I can't answer, I really enjoy it.
I used to think that, you know, teaching was done in classrooms, with the teacher standing at the board, but not anymore.
I was tempted to stay closer to home and go to a university in the northeast, but I thought I'd regret not coming to Oxford more than I'd regret not going to one of the other universities that I applied to.
Obviously you need to have knowledge in the first place, but you need to be able to do something with it. And that's really what we're looking for. So we'll start with things that you probably have come across before or ought to be able to work out for yourself. And then we'll probe how far we can take you with it.
They want to see what you're like when they throw numbers at you, throw a bit of data at you, but they ease you in, that they're not monsters.
We don't expect you to know lots of abstruse things that are outside the syllabus, but we do expect you to know the stuff that you've been taught, and we expect you to understand it.
I just remember opening my letter and I was like, I couldn't believe it because I thought my interview had gone terribly. I thought there was no chance I was in. So I was like, yay!
That's one of the best things about chemistry. It leaves so many doors open once you finish.
Most of our students stay in chemistry in some form or other. Many of them go on to further degrees in chemistry or into the chemical industry. There are major chemical industries in the country, and they're all looking for good, well-qualified chemists.
I have a year of 8 people. Of that, 3 of them are going to study DPhils, take on further study. The rest of them are going to work as professionals in a wide variety of fields, from law to banking to management consulting. You can do anything with it.
I'm using my fourth year as a kind of test to see if maybe I want to go into research.
I may not be reading through my chemistry textbooks over the next 20 years, but I will certainly be taking the skills that I've learned when I did read those chemistry textbooks and applying them to life outside of chemistry.
I think definitely something with science. It hasn't killed my love for science at all. So I definitely want to use my chemistry knowledge in the rest of my life.
If you're sitting there thinking, yeah, I really could see myself reading about chemistry for 4 years, then you're going to love it. You really are.